This is Windows 11 with Windows XP and Linux Fusion on it. We're gonna see if it's worth the mod. Straight into installation, the look of it has been changed to use the old Windows logo as well as using grey as its background. Oh, there's a question. Are you OS first timer? Oh come on guys, I'm not OS first timer! I'm just someone who listens too much from Philip that my accent is similar to Philip's. Okay, the boot screen is Windows 11 still, I mean, I don't really care about it. Oh wait, another question. What's your passion? Well, Windows, Linux, literal language, management and leadership in general. Okay, no OOB so far. We're straight into the desktop. The desktop looks a bit Windows XP-like with a different recycle bin icon, which I assume is from a Linux icon pack. The taskbar is quite Windows XP, and the start menu's layout is quite Windows XP as you can see in this comparison. Looking at this PC, there are two changes as the look of the app is very different when it comes to the theme with different caption box buttons, as well as icons and design inside which I think looks quite good. Another change in look appears in control panel, which uses icons from a Linux icon pack, which I'm pretty sure this is what modern Ubuntu, just kidding, like what Ubuntu icons look like. Oh, another question. What is the best video you've made in your opinion? Well, what's this? Which gained over 200,000 views as of today, which I can't comprehend it at first, and it ended up blowing my channel, so yeah. Taking a look at the start menu, UWP apps are mostly removed with Windows Security, Unremovable Get Started, Store, Settings, Notepad and Paint as exceptions. In the other side, legacy applications from Windows XP were added such as Calculator. Oh, by the way, thank you for showing today's subscriber count so that you all don't forget to subscribe to everything Windows so that I can reach 6,000 subscribers ASAP. Okay, and another applications like Notepad, Paint, and WordPad. Windows games, which were mixes from XP, Vista, and 7 were added in here, in this case, 3D Pinball. What is your name inspiration? Well, this channel's name is not fully inspired by anything, but I came up with the name after Windows Everything as the initial name got taken and I don't want to make myself similar to the existing channel. So I reversed the name and Everything Windows, but there was another channel with that name, so yeah. By the way, here's another example. Spider Solitaire. How many languages you speak? Well, fluently English and Indonesian, but for conversation level, it's Arabia and Mafok language. For understanding level, it's Ruski, Francais, and Little Savanchina. And those that I'm still learning are Hindi, Deutsch, Zhongwe, Spanyol, and Nihongo. So, 11 languages that I learn at least. Speaking of sounds, the Hysteria sound scheme uses Windows XP sound as far as I hear. We got 8 themes which vary as you can see progressively. What first got you into Windows things as an enthusiast, and why did you decide to make it your hobby? Well, my dad got me when I was 7 back in 2012 with a Windows XP family computer. Yeah, so thanks to my parents who just basically built the foundation of my channel as a whole. Everything is the prioritized internal search engine in Project Hysteria, and I use this IRL and trust me, it's damn faster than Windows Search. Since this is basically Windows 11, you can install modern applications with Microsoft Store, but what I'm interested in right now is installing from an old app installer, which takes you to the Microsoft Store webpage and grabs packages automatically from there. And from here, I can install WhatsApp to see the Everything Windows WhatsApp community, which you can join, the link will be in the description. And not just modern software, but 16-bit software is supported with OTVDM by using Windows 3.1's calculator as an example. Oh yeah, don't forget about the nostalgic shutdown dialect from Windows XP. It's really cool. This project was made by DMAX over my Discord server, which you can join also. The link will be in the description of this video. As far as this mod goes to show, there aren't many perfect things. Example, which I noticed, the Windows 7 icon remnants still exist in control panel. Other than those changes, well, there's all I can see. And you can download this mod, the link will be in the description, and as far as I know, this looks like macOS 10. If you're unsure, you can check out this video. Meanwhile, like and share this video, thank you to my 5 supporters for making this video possible, and also don't forget to check out this video.